I have been a member of Alcoholics Anonymous from January 13th, 2011, which was my last drink. So prior to January 13th, 2011, I drank for a period of 20 years. In that 10 years, I enjoyed my drinking. 5 years was very painful. The next 5 years, I drank because I don't know how to stop. I had a desire to stop, but I don't know how to stop. Every day I was praying to God to make me stop. I was even cursing God, saying that either you lift me away my drinking problem or you kill me. I cannot continue like this drinking. This was my last 5 years. During this period, I did all sorts of problems with my life in the last 5 years. Everything got messed up. And it was down the line a deterioration. And I was admitted into a treatment facility on January 13th, 2011. That's how my drinking stopped. I stayed there for a period of 4 months, where I was got introduced to the Big Book. On May 13th, 2011, I attended my first Alcoholics Anonymous group meeting, which was on Friday evening. I went to that meeting and sat, not with a desire to stop completely alcohol, but I went to the meeting because for me, living in the home was hell at that time. It was very problematic and chaos. So I went and sat in the meeting. And there, so today's my topic is principles, but not personalities. In that meeting, I saw people who were well-dressed, people who were coming in cars, people who were neatly groomed than me, people who were much educated than me. So slowly I started looking at, I need to have things that what these people are having. These people are rich, they are having money, they are coming in cars, they are living a luxury life. So I slowly got attracted into those things, but still not yet with a complete desire to stop drinking, because I still did not believe that these people have stopped drinking. Or I was under this thought that, these people might be drinking once in a while, or on some occasions, like birthday parties, or any events, festivals, holidays. How can somebody stop drinking and claim themselves that they are actually enjoying my life? These type of thoughts were going on. Slowly started believing in the program because I had some visual proofs that I could see people relapsing, coming back to the meeting and sharing their experiences that they have relapsed, and these are the things that had happened to them. Then I started believing, yes, these people, what they are saying is truth. As days went by, my journey was so painful. Even I was away from alcohol. I was not drinking, but there was a lot of chaos in my life. My wife actually told many times, when I was abstinent to why don't I die? Why I am living? What is the use of me living? What is the purpose? What big difference I have made to not drinking and life? All these things, there were multiple times, almost maybe more than 100 times she might have told me to either leave the home or die, and she is least bothered whether I am alive or dead. And these things never, I have never experienced when I was drinking, these type of words. Actually, I got married in 2002, February. And that 9 years of life, she never told me these things. But when I was not drinking, she told me these things many times. And it was very, very painful for me to not to understand where I am called, or even to understand that what I am doing wrong. So, and it's not that I'm not aware that I need to do the steps. I was very clearly aware, because from the rehab which I came out, they gave me a discharge summary saying that I need to go to meetings, need to take a sponsor, start working the steps. It was very clearly mentioned. So I was desperately looking out for a sponsor, asking people. Some of them said that they have done, but they don't have time. Some of them said that they have not done. One person asked me to do the fifth step and come. And finally, I got a sponsor who was not doing anything with me. Actually, I was chasing him. When will you take me through the steps? When will you take me through the steps? But he was not doing anything. And finally, a person approached me, who is currently also my sponsor. And he asked me, am I interested in doing the steps? I said yes. That's how my journey started into recovery. And slowly, as he took me through the steps, he told me, buddy, your business is over only half. Now the real journey starts. And he took me through the traditions, where we got into the 12 traditions, practicing each tradition 3 weeks, 1 week in AA, 1 week in home, 1 week at work. Then after that, I meet with my sponsor every week for a review. So that has been happening. So when it came to the 12th tradition, it reads like this. Anonymity is the spiritual foundation of all our traditions, ever reminding us to place principles before personalities. In Telugu it reads, వ్యక్తిత్వముల కన్నా నియమములు ప్రధానమైనవి. ఎల్లప్పుడూ మనకు గుర్తు చేస్తూ ఉండే గుప్తత మన అన్న సాంప్రదాయముకు ఆధ్యాత్మిక పునాది. సో వెన్ ఐ స్టార్టెడ్ ప్రాక్టీసింగ్ దిస్ ట్రెడిషన్, ఐ అండర్స్టూడ్ వన్ థింగ్. స్టెప్స్ ఆర్ ఫర్ మై పర్సనల్ రికవరీ. traditions are for recovery of the groups. There is a slight difference between steps and traditions. If I don't do these steps, maybe I will alone die. But if I don't practice the traditions, I'll become a homicide. So if I don't practice the traditions, it's not that I will die, it's the whole group dies, or I will kill the group. And in this, I have to always remember principles, not personalities. So I got a little bit confused here, because in the big book, in Hobbit words, it very clearly says, if you want what we have and are willing to go to any length, then you are ready to take certain steps. When I came to AA, I was not looking at recovery. I was looking at how people are coming, what type of dresses they are wearing, what type of vehicles they are coming, how they are spending their life, how they were spending money. These materialistic things I was looking at. And I wanted that, because my only goal in life is to have ample money, travel around the world, and make good friends. And in that, part of it is also drinking. Today, as a result of this program, except for the drink part, remaining all things are happening, excluding the money. I have good friends today. I have friends throughout the country. And with the result of my sponsorship chain, I was able to make good friends around the world. So I lead a better life today. For that, I need to put these principles ahead of everything. So what are these principles? What I need to do? These underlining principles, what they teach? The tradition 1 talks about commonwealth, and tradition 12 talks about anonymity. And when it comes to anonymity, where it clearly says, anonymity is a genuine humility, and I need to sacrifice certain things. To keep this Alcoholics Anonymous alive for the coming generations. Like when I came to Alcoholics Anonymous, I don't know what is Alcoholics Anonymous. Nobody told me what is Alcoholics Anonymous. Nobody gave me any sort of information that what I need to do over here. But what I have seen is, unknowingly, I started doing right things. Unknowingly, I took a home group. Unknowingly, I started getting involved into service. Unknowingly, I understood that that group has been alive. By the time I reached to that group, it was 25 years. So those people have kept the door of Alcoholics Anonymous open to me for 25 years. And slowly that group gave me certain responsibilities, like opening the meeting, And after giving that responsibilities, I started taking up that responsibility. Slowly I learned. As I went through the practice of the traditions, I understood certain spiritual principles. Like, one of the spiritual principles is very important that I have seen is about group conscious. Everything in AA, Alcoholics Anonymous, happens by discussion, vote, and without discussing, things will not happen. Here, in my initial days, my home group used to do anniversaries. And whenever there was an anniversary, at that time only we used to have business meeting. And in that business meeting, we used to talk only about financial aspects. And these business meetings were most postponed because of certain members have not come. So, at a later stage, today, what we are doing is, we are putting a message, we are putting an information that there is a group business meeting. Whether the members who are attending, we see whether there is a quorum form. Like, if there are 10 people, 7 people need to attend for a home group. 2/3 of the majority, the group members come, then there is a quorum and the meeting can happen. Irrespective of, in my group, if there is a person who is the founder of that group, if it doesn't come also, we need not have to wait for him. Because AA should move on. AA doesn't depend on a person or his conformity or neither his personality. AA should move on. AA should go to take care of his business. That is what traditions have taught me, that AA will not stop for anyone, neither with me. It should go on. I should rely on the group, not the group should rely on me. So that is what that principle has taught me of group conscious, that it will go forward and it will not wait for anyone if there is a quorum. The second principle that I have learned in AA is that if anyone who is having a desire to stop drinking, they are all welcome. Irrespective of age, color, creed, sex, what social status, educational status, for anything, we cannot remove any person from any group unless and until he wants to go out. He can be a member of the home group. And at the same time, he can also change his home groups. In my home group, there was a member who took, he asked, can I become a member of your home group? I said, yes. Then after 6 months, he said that, no, I want to go to another group. I said, fine. It's your choice. Here nobody governs or nobody dictates you that you need to do. Everything in Alcoholics Anonymous is a mere suggestion. And each member is autonomous. He can do whatever he feels like.
it's not compulsory or mandatory that a person needs to do steps or follow traditions to become a member of Alcoholics Anonymous. To become a member of Alcoholics Anonymous, he needs just to have a desire to stop drinking. It is not even requirement that it is saying that they need to stop drinking. It's up to him whether he wants to continue drinking or he doesn't want to continue drinking. The only condition that they say is, if that person is disturbing the meeting, then that person can be asked to leave the meeting and ask him to come tomorrow. Because keeping in view of the meeting a smooth conduction, the way it needs to be conducted, if it is being a disturbance, then we can take that step. The most important principle that I have learned is, which very clearly our preamble states, that AA is not allied with any sect, denomination, politics, organization or institution. So here I used to get a lot of calls from NGOs, organizations, where they were having the meetings regarding the prohibition of alcohol or reformation of alcohol, and they used to call us. We used to very clearly tell them, our intention is not that. We actually like people who can safely drink. We are not against drinking. And we are not saying that they need to stop drinking. We are a group of people who are who has a problem with alcohol and who has a desire to stop drinking, they are welcome. We are not into cooperation with anyone. We are not into affiliation with anyone. We just cooperate. Here I will share you a small experience. Last year, in the month of July or August, I exactly don't remember. We had to go to meet the additional DGP of Cyberabad Commissionerate. Additional traffic DGP of Cyberabad Commissionerate, Rachakonda Commissionerate, sorry. Where they were putting an exhibition in Sarur Nagar Stadium. So they wanted to display of our kiosk. So we took the pictures of the kiosk, sat in front of the additional DGP. So he was asked to make changes. You have to change the color, you have to remove the languages, you have to put it only in Telugu, etc. Blah 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 blah. So I told him, sir, it is not possible, sir. We are giving you information about Alcoholics Anonymous. And we, since this is a city where the all languages, the national language, the English language and the Telugu language, we need to display. So that anybody who is in a position to read or the understand the language will get the information about the Alcoholics Anonymous, and we will display our pamphlets also. So the additional DGP asked me, do we have any traditions? Yeah, we have traditions, and we follow as per that. I am an ordinary citizen who, if not Alcoholics Anonymous, I don't even have the opportunity to go and just meet him also, sitting in front of him, talking about the principles. And the most interesting principle that wherever I find the people get lot of attention or attraction about Alcoholics Anonymous is the principle of self-support. When we go and meet the government officials or the doctors or the police officers, they will ask only one thing: how do you get money? What is that is your intention to do these things? Only two answers. Sir, we don't take money from anyone outside. We take only money from people who are alcoholics and who are willing to contribute. Second, we do these things for free and for fun, and primarily to keep ourselves sober. So they get shocked. That is the biggest attraction of Alcoholics Anonymous. Because we don't promote, we are not selling Alcoholics Anonymous. We are attractively placing our recoveries in front of people, where this utilizing this principle of anonymity, where I need not have to break anonymity is press, radio, films, and World Wide Web, where I cannot post my photograph. I cannot put my full name. Rather than that, I will request the press, radio, or the World Wide Web to display the name of Alcoholics Anonymous ahead of my name, and stating I am member of Alcoholics Anonymous, not my full name, giving only my first name or any nickname, so that I am not recognized. And that is where the whole attraction of Alcoholics Anonymous comes with respect to media, where we are a group of people who are not interested in any sort of name, fame, or recognition. We are placing the organization's name ahead of our name and giving the promotion of alcoholic the name of Alcoholics Anonymous, giving the information about Alcoholics Anonymous. So this, when we practice to put principles ahead of personalities, these principles can be practiced even at my work and my home also, where I learn how to sacrifice, and where I learn that I am doing these things not for any recognition or name or fame or anything. I simply do it for as part of my duty or responsibility for that day. And in this process, neither I don't take any ownership of recovering anyone, because this program is very, very simple. It says that probably no human power could relieve our alcoholism. I cannot cure anyone. Neither I am a cause to anyone's relapse. It all depends on that individual and his relationship that he is having with his higher power to keep himself sober, what he is doing for that day. My job is to just share my experience, strength, and hope. And what finally I have seen is these traditions are a bit difficult to practice in my day-to-day life, because it always talks about all the remaining traditions are focusing only on one thing, primary purpose, common man. What is the primary purpose of Alcoholics Anonymous? And for that, to keep Alcoholics Anonymous alive today, what I am sacrificing and how I am doing it. There, I am not giving any importance to any personality. I am giving importance to principles, whether people will come with me or not. I will share you an experience, and with that I will come to an end with my sharing. In my home group, we had a lot of money that got accumulated, and the one of the person who was holding the account, he died. So I started asking people, what about that money that is in the bank? When will we remove it? And in my group, with that aspect, nobody was interested in taking any action. Everybody started talking about, what can we do? That person has died. No. Who will go to bank? Who will take care of all those things, etc., blah, blah, blah. I used to question each of my home group member, if it is your own personal money, you will be also saying the same thing, or you will put some effort? But that didn't help. So finally, I approached one more person and asked his help. He said that, okay, I can help you out, but you go back and discuss with your group members and tell me, what are you going to do with that money? Are you going to send it to a upper service body like the area committee and the general service office, or you are going to keep it with you? He came back, we had a discussion, and in this discussion, one of the member who was having the authorized bank signatory had didn't turn up to that meeting. Another couple of members who were also one of the old timers of our group, they didn't turn up. We took the decision. We gave yes. We said that we will not even keep 1 rupee with us. We will send it to the upper service body. Finally, that amount came out. And once that amount came out, I started receiving calls. It is our group's money, no? Why we need to send it to upper service body? Why can't we keep it with us? I only asked him one question. When there was a business meeting, what were you doing? Why you have not turned up? You should have raised your voice then. Now you did not attend that business meeting. Neither you were not part of it. But when money came, you are questioning us. Now already the group has taken a call, and we are not going to step back. And to the person whom I was talking, he is almost double of my sobriety, 2.5 times. But I did not take a step back, because I put principle ahead of him. In the same way, whenever we get an opportunity in talking about traditions, we see certain groups following violating certain traditions, like mother group, sister group, brother group. We ask only one thing. Are you not violating a tradition that each group is autonomous? who asked you that there is a mother group, there is a sister group, there is a brother group? If that is the case, we should be all going under the Akron group, which is the first group of Alcoholics Anonymous that started way back in June 10th, 1935. But that is not the case. They are saying that each group is autonomous. So stick to the principle rather than personality. At the same way, the basic difference between steps and traditions is, to do the steps I need not have to understand, but to practice these traditions I need to understand and read a lot of literature. So to understand the program of Alcoholics Anonymous, there is a lot of literature that is available in the form of pamphlets, workbooks, guidelines, books. Unless and until I don't read all those things, I don't understand about the importance of the reading the literature and how to implement it, I cannot practice these principles ahead of personalities. I get carried away with personalities, and my participation in Alcoholics Anonymous will be bare minimum. If I have to keep my sobriety intact, I need to participate in Alcoholics Anonymous, and I also need to put a principle ahead of a personality. And last but not the least, I was just going through the this group's invitation, where they have mentioned that we follow all the 12 traditions. So I would like to suggest to this group, take this as an open mind suggestion. When we have put all the traditions, I suggest that this group to each meeting, they put an online kitty also. Let that money come and utilize that money in the proper way by sending it to upper service bodies or buy literature, distribute it in whatever way so that the message gets carried to the still suffering alcoholic. And I thank the members of this group for inviting me. And I also would like to give a quote that I am not speaking on behalf of Alcoholics Anonymous as a whole. I'm just a member of Alcoholics Anonymous, and this is my personal experience, strength, and hope I'm sharing. I thank you for giving me the opportunity to share. Thank you.